Welcome, friends, to this cozy little cottage. Please, sit down, grab a cup of hot cocoa, and make yourselves at home. Ah, the weenies. The most prestigious award. To get one's hands on a weenie is the dream of many a men and women. So gather round and listen close, as some have already won their very own. Let us see who has ever been so lucky. Most deserving, I'd say. But it is now time for me to reveal my very own weenie.
Besting D game!
Baldur's Gate 3 has got to be one of the best games I've ever played. Even though it was still in early access at the time of me playing it,
why is he black?
I finished the game having only great things to say. From the combat to the dialogue, the art direction and the character design.
What the fuck is— what is that?!
It is all just overflowing with soul. The game is just so satisfying to play. Beating a boss and their cronies, carefully planning and coordinating every move with your allies, cutting as close as you can, it's an experience that's unmatched. Not to mention, it's only enhanced with every single friend you play with. Larian bros, we can't stop winning.
Damn, Lizelle's ass just taking up the frame.
Dominating the scene right now.
Speaking of soul,
I fucking hate this game!
The Skywalker Saga is nothing. It feels like someone took an AI and told it to make a LEGO game, then fed it with everything other than LEGO games. This is a trend that all newer LEGO games seem to have been on for some time, just implementing the usual schlock of modern day video games. But this one is extra disappointing. Having played the classic LEGO Star Wars games as a child, and to this day still going back to revisit them, there's a glaringly obvious lack of soul, a clear ignorance regarding why the originals are so fondly remembered. Characters now having fully voiced dialogue removes any possibility for the old sense of humor of the classic games. Which isn't inherently an issue, but what they replace the old sense of humor with is the equivalent of empty calories, something only a child could laugh at.
Fuck this shit! Fuck this garbage-ass shit! I played 21 hours of this, trying to find something worth anything.
The old games could have easily slapped in dialogue straight from the movie, like every other Star Wars game before it did, but instead they opted to not use any dialogue at all. They used slapstick humor that was so pure and just genuinely funny. Meta gags that could only be done well with this limitation. I could go on and on about the reasons why I don't think the Skywalker Saga lives up to the classics, but it unfortunately serves as yet another example of the modern gaming industry as a whole lacking something that the games of old did not.
Best movie!
Possum is Kino. Plain and simple, it's a spooky, disturbing, and genuinely dark film. It takes you for a winding ride, making you second-guess your predictions several times through its short hour-and-a-half runtime. The amount of fantastic cinematography, acting, and writing that's on display is something to admire. That's all I'm gonna say for now, as I don't want to spoil it for anyone, but I genuinely recommend everyone go watch it.
Biggest surprise, rise.
I did not care for the
new Call of Duty.
What?
As someone who does not care for the new style and direction Call of Duty is committed to, I found myself constantly yearning to go back to play the classics like Black Ops 2. The glory days before skill-based matchmaking, shitty UIs, an insane and inconsistent time to kill, back when COD was COD. So, while this doesn't technically count as it's not a single game, nor is it new, the Plutonium Project genuinely made my year. Reviving the CODs of old, from World at War to Modern Warfare 3, it allowed me to once again play the games that I longed for since Modern Warfare 2019. With a relatively large player base, community servers, and some cut content added in, you can play peak COD as if it had never gone away. There was not a time when playing where I wasn't smiling, laughing, and just having a blast.
Oh, that was it.
What the hell? I just heard that. I just heard it like...
It was just like back when I was 12 years old, getting home from the midnight release of Black Ops 2 and getting to play it for the first time with my friends.
What do you got for that one?
I just walked out of a building.
Grenade!
Most disappointing game.
Now everyone knows my love for the dogs is well documented, from my shirt, the clear influence from Morgan, and the fathead of Vince Dooley on the front of my house. But I gotta say, Georgia vs. Tennessee was just a letdown. You would not believe the amount of hype surrounding this game. Georgia, the defending national champs, unbeaten, looking rock solid. However, some slower games against nobody teams put some doubt in people's minds if they could beat real teams. Then, on the other side, you got Tennessee, coming out of nowhere on the hottest streak in all of college football, beating everyone and beating them bad. Led by Hendon Hooker, a prodigy quarterback that brought Tennessee out of irrelevance into the discussion of winning the Natty. Only 2 weeks before this game, they beat Alabama in an incredibly close victory that came down to a last-second field goal after an insane final drive. Everyone was calling the Alabama game the best game of the season, and for good reason. Now, the Natty before the Natty. Both teams have a lot to prove and a lot to lose. Can Stetson Bennett prove once again that he was the real deal? Could Hendon Hooker use his incredible wide receiver? No. No, he couldn't. This game put to rest everyone who ever doubted Georgia, including my coworker, who went into work the next week looking like a dad who had just walked in on his daughter getting railed by five dudes and her brother.
No!
Complete dejection and disappointment. It was so bad, it was boring to watch. All I can ask is, Tennessee.
What happened?
Now, this is a game I had to come back to in order to truly appreciate and understand the magnitude of, and I'm gonna say it, Elden Ring is a masterpiece. It is truly something to behold. The amount of content, while jarring at first, is unmatched by any other title that released this year. With this title, FromSoft, I believe, have perfected the Souls-like genre. Every boss is the equivalent of the noob filter that Pontiff Sullivan was in Dark Souls 3. Putting much more emphasis on co-op play with bosses allows for some of the more dramatic experiences in all of their games. The variety of builds and ways to play, much like the previous entries, allows for an insane amount of replayability, not to mention the fantastic as usual story and lore of the game. it's much more similar to what Dark Souls 2 was, before the nostalgia baiting and callbacks that plagued Dark Souls 3. How FromSoft have perfected the movement mechanics from their games allows for this game to be one of the smoothest feeling games on the market. For this, and many other reasons, I have Elden Ring as my game of the year. Ready or Not is everything I hoped for out of a SWAT game and more. There's not a single thing where I've been let down. The amount of content added to this game since the early access launch is insane. The gunplay is next level and the AI is crazy difficult to deal with. Make a single wrong move, not checking your corner, forgetting to check for traps. Even leaving a civilian unhandcuffed could get you killed and having to restart the entire mission. The freedom you have is also pretty surprising. There are always numerous ways to enter a building to take care of an objective, but those options are also available for the suspects who will use them to flank you or retreat to a different position that you previously had cleared. Want to go in California style? Boom, several non-lethal options. Civvy talking smack to you as you apprehend him? Boom, pistol whip to the back of the head. You may lose some points, but that's a sacrifice I'm more than happy to take. A guy dropped his gun and is on the floor with his hands up. Safe, right? Wrong. You just caught a blade to the throat, dumbass. Think the crackhead is unarmed? Wrong. Think the civvy will just stand there? Nope, they went and grabbed a gun off the dude you just smoked next to them, and now they're shooting at you. There is no game I've been more impressed by this year than Ready or Not, and it is easily one of my top 10 games, period. The game isn't even finished yet, it's only up from here. The devs are constantly putting out updates and devlogs. Goaty with the sauce, uncontested. There was no other game it could have been. I never even finished Elden Ring. I never even thought of picking it back up. It didn't cross my mind. Could you imagine?